Hello and welcome to Introduction to Lookeen 2026. My name is Alexander Kainz and I'm the lead developer of Lookeen, and I will be showing you the main features of Lookeen 2026, and we'll get right into it. Right, so this is the main window of Lookeen, and on the top we have the search bar where we can type in our searches. Let's just use the invoice that we have already selected. And we'll see the results. And let me go back here. And then on the left, we can filter and explore the results. This is, we can, for example, just say like files, right? I will come back to that. Then in the middle, we have the result documents, the list of result documents rather. And if we click on a document, we'll see the preview of the document. And on the left is the invoice that we typed in here. So this one, it's a word from the query. And if we click on this arrow, we will see the next location where it's in the document, right? So if I scroll down here, we'll see this is invoice. If we had a second word, we could select the second word, for example, tax. Then we could have like tax here and go to the word tax in this document. This highlighting works for Word documents, it works for Excel sheets, it works for PDFs, it works for HTMLs, and all kinds of documents. On the top, we have the AI button. We're going to get to that in a second. Below the query bar, we have the view, which allows us to view into the search results, right? So if I click mails, it doesn't change the search results. If you see that everything is still the same, files is still the same, they still exist, right? But now we're viewing it only a certain subset of the result, right? These are all mails. And if we want to actually say, I only want to see mails, I want to filter mails. For example, I could just click here. Now the type is mails. That's a filter on the left side. And everything contains only mails, zero files, and just those mails. And then we can also filter by file type, right? We can say documents, which are PDF documents, HTML documents, EPUB documents, anything like that. So if we click it, there's a document we saw earlier. And if I click this away, we also have office documents. So if I only want to see office documents, then I can filter like this, right? Or I could only say like only Word documents, only docx, Word documents, excuse me. Then we can filter by size. We can say only large documents, right? Or only very large documents, larger than 1 megabyte. We can filter by date. So let's say I want to see the invoice from last month, then this is possible by filtering by date. Or if I want to say like all the invoices from this year, obviously those are not my invoices, but you know, imagine that they were, I could see all the invoices from this year. Then we can filter by source. Where is the document coming from? Is it coming from Exchange? Or is it coming from the file system? And we can, if we go to files, we can also filter by path, right? So this is where the files are actually located. And you could just say like, you know, I just want to see this path, or maybe I know it's in this folder. And then it will filter by folder as well. And now let's take this away. We can also filter by exchange, which allows us to go into the account in Exchange or in Outlook or in Outlook 365. We can filter by email address, which is really just me since I'm the only one who got those mails. And we have the document. So let's go to the more advanced features of Lookeen. But to do this, let's enable the column filters first. So column filters is another way to filter. By using column filters, we can just specify invoice here, for example, and now it has to be in the name. If you look at the documents, you can see all of them have invoice in the name. All of these mails have invoice in the name, right? So this is specific. If you type in invoice up here, it can be name, it can be the content, it can be anything, right? If you type in invoice here, it will only be the name. And the same goes for date, size, path, right? I want to be only inbox, then they will be here, and the tags. And let's talk about the tags for a second. The tags is also a new feature that we have here. We use tag, and now we can say like, oh, this is relevant for my tags, right? So we create a new tag called tags and assign it to this document, right? We see now it has the tags. Maybe I could have used another word, but I went for tags. So it has the single tag called tags. And now if I remove all the queries, right, let's no more queries. And then, you know, let's say I want to find out which documents are my tags relevant documents. I can just click on the filter here, tags. And then I will just see this document that has been tagged as tags, right? And this is also possible via the column filter, if you see it up here. So tags do follow documents around. They're not stored in the document, but they follow. If the document is not changed and moved to a different folder, it will keep its tags. Like if I move it from, like, you know, to archive, it would still keep its tags. So that's a really cool technology. It's also the same technology that we use to identify duplicates. If I go to my exchange mails, let me close those column filters. It goes by like this little filter icon here. And then we see like this test, local test email is an outbox, but it has this little icon. And if I hover over the icon, it says there's a hidden duplicate, namely in inbox. So it's in the outbox and in the inbox. So it's just to declutter your search results. Simply this document is in here and in inbox. Like oftentimes you have them in send or outbox and then you don't want to see them twice, right? You can configure this in the settings if you want to turn it off, or if you want to be look at the content, or if you want to just look by name. That is configurable and is also a new feature for Lookeen 2026. Let's take this out. Let's go back to our invoice document. Let me use the filter here, invoice. I already saw the document, it's right there. And then we want to use the AI to summarize the document. So summarize sends this to our AI provider. That basically it extracts the text. We already can extract the text for like many, many file types like PDFs, documents, Word documents, Excel sheets. We are able to extract this text. So we send the text to the AI provider together with a prompt. And then, for example, summarize here, we'll summarize the document and we'll see, like, without, you know, having the PDF, we will see what the document contains. Now we could ask the document questions like, are these prices fair? So, oops, let me get the Windows menu gone. I think that's what I wanted to show, right? So we have the filters up here, we have the queries up here, we have the filters and the explore view on the left. We have the column filters, we have the previews with highlighting, we have the duplicate detection, we have the tagging, right? That allows us to tag documents. We have the AI features, and that's about it. And thank you very much for watching.